Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 21st of December. Indian farmers begin relay hunger strike against farm laws. Government presses for talks. Death toll rises to at least 10 in Kabul car bomb attack. And Nepal heads to surprise election next year after Prime Minister Oli dissolves parliament. And now for all the details. Farmer unions on Monday began a day-long relay hunger strike at all protest sites at borders of Indian capital New Delhi to press for the repeal of newly passed farm laws. This comes as the government has invited representatives of the protesting farmers for fresh talks to end the deadlock as the agitation entered its 26th day on Monday.
Intensifying their agitation against new agricultural laws, Indian farmers began their day-long relay hunger strike on Monday at all sites of protest at Indian capital New Delhi's borders with Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. A group of 12 farmers' unions sat on hunger strike for 24 hours. After 24 hours, another group of 11 farmers' unions was scheduled to begin the hunger strike in a bid to intensify the agitation that entered its 26th day on Monday. Meanwhile, the centre government has invited representatives of the protesting farmers to engage in further talks to end the deadlock, which has led to thousands camping on the outskirts of New Delhi for more than 3 weeks.
पर जेकर जो प्रस्ताव हैं हमको वो मैंने नहीं रखते हैं उस प्रस्ताव के हम गलबात करने के लिए तैयार नहीं हैं हमारा एक ही प्रस्ताव अपना है कि हम जो सरकार को देके आए गए 5 दिसंबर को कि इन कानूनों को रद्द किया जाए
Farmers have been protesting for nearly a month over the reforms enacted in September, which will allow them to sell their produce to buyers beyond government-regulated wholesale markets. Small farmers fear the changes will mean the end of guaranteed minimum prices for their crops and leave them at the mercy of big retailers.
India may begin vaccinating people for COVID-19 in January, Health Minister Harshvardhan has said, adding that the government's priority has been the safety and efficacy of vaccine. The remarks came at a time when India's COVID-19 tally has crossed the 10 million mark with at least 145,810 deaths.
India may start vaccinating its people against COVID-19 from January, said Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan, who also assured the government's first priority is safety and efficacy of the vaccine. Harshvardhan, in an exclusive interview to ANI News Agency on Sunday, said, maybe in January, in any stage or any week, there can be a time when we can be in a position to give first COVID vaccine shot to people of India. The minister informed that the vaccines, including those who have applied for emergency use authorization, are being analyzed by the regulator.
हमारी योग्यता और क्षमता में किसी प्रकार की कमी नहीं है और हमने पूरी तैयारी की है नीचे लेवल तक पूरे स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को इन्वॉल्व करके स्टेट के लेवल पर टास्क फोर्स बनाकर डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पर ब्लॉक लेवल पर
Amid concerns over the new coronavirus strain in the UK, Harshvardhan on Monday said the government is alert and there is no need to panic. India has passed the 10 million milestone mark over the past weekend, but the rate of new infections has slowed considerably since a September peak. A total of 145,810 people in India have died of COVID-19, with 333 deaths in the past 24 hours, according to the Health Ministry data.
India witnessed extreme cold wave conditions aggravated by heavy fog across northern part on Monday. Most of the cities in the northern region recorded their lowest temperatures of the season. Residents in several cities were seen struggling to carry out their daily activities in the bone-chilling cold. While some sat near the fire to warm themselves, others sipped tea to beat the cold. The northwest India is likely to experience relief from the severe cold conditions soon as the India Meteorological Department predicted a gradual rise in minimum and maximum temperatures by 2 to 3 degrees Celsius over plains of northwest and adjoining central India, including Indian capital New Delhi, during the next 48 hours.
ठंड तो बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ ही रहा है धीरे धीरे अब आग का अलाव लोग ताप रहे हैं अपना जीवन यापन कर रहे हैं रोजगार भी ठप है लोग को
मूविंग ऑन अ प्रोटेस्ट वॉज रिसेंटली हेल्ड बाई लोकल्स इन गिलगित बाल्टिस्तान टू एक्सप्रेस एंगर ओवर फ्रीक्वेंट लोड शेडिंग इन द इलीगली ऑक्यूपाइड रीजन द प्रोटेस्टर्स कंप्लेन डिस्पाइट पेइंग हेफ्टी बिल्स देयर वॉज नो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन सेवरल एरियाज फॉर द पास्ट वन मंथ
Scores of locals recently held a protest and blocked roads in Gilgit-Baltistan against frequent load shedding in parts of the illegally occupied region. The protesters expressed they are having a distressing time due to the prolonged power cuts, expanding to more than 18 hours, which have hit normal life. Some of them complained they had come out to protest on roads as there is no electricity in Konadas, Skardu and several other areas for more than a month.
अब इस टाइम ये हाल है कि यहाँ पे 18-18 घंटा बिजली चली जाती है और जहाँ पे लोग इस टैक्स को देते नहीं है बिजली के बिल को देते नहीं है वहाँ पे बिजली के लोग मज़े ले रहे हैं
कोई एक महीना हुआ एक महीने से हमारे साथ बिल्कुल बिजली हमारे कोनोदास एरिया नगर कॉलोनी सरकार कॉलोनी में बिजली बिल्कुल ही नहीं है ना उसी बिजली के बिना पे हमें पानी से हम महरूम हैं हमारे घर से हमारे माएँ हमारी बहनें दरिया जाती हैं वहाँ से पानी लाना में बहुत मुश्किल होती हैं
Locals have time and again accused Pakistan of meting out a stepmotherly treatment to the illegally occupied region, failing to develop the infrastructure and leaving them high and dry. However, this seems a new low that Islamabad has stooped to in order to harass them.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. At a time when resumption of the Afghan peace negotiations from January is in doubt, The High Council for National Reconciliation in Afghanistan has said that the process should resume as soon as possible. Afghan peace talks, which were being held in Doha since September, were halted last week.
The High Council for National Reconciliation in Afghanistan has said that the result of the Afghan government team's five-day consultation with political leaders and politicians has been that the second round of negotiations should resume at the scheduled time, which is January 5. The negotiators from Doha who are in Kabul are expected to meet lawmakers, the leadership committee of the Reconciliation Council and the public during their stay. Fridun Khwazun, a spokesman for the High Council for National Reconciliation, informed there won't be any problem from the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan side. He asserted that the government is ready to hold the talks at their scheduled time. Meanwhile, the US peace envoy, Zalmay Khalilzad, in a series of tweets on Sunday reiterated his call on the Afghan warring parties to swiftly end the violence and agree to a political settlement to end the conflict as soon as possible. Afghan peace talks, which were being held in Doha since September, were halted last week. Both warring sides, Afghan government and the Taliban, are now struggling to reach consensus over the venue of the talks resuming from January 5.
More on news from Afghanistan. Civilians continue to bear the brunt of rising violence in war-torn Afghanistan. The death toll in Sunday's car bombing targeting an Afghan lawmaker in Kabul rose to at least 10 on Monday. Separate bombings were also reported on Sunday in several other provinces in which civilians and members of the security forces were killed.
Death toll in Sunday's car bomb attack targeting an Afghan lawmaker has risen to at least 10, officials confirmed on Monday. Lawmaker Khan Mohammad Wardak survived the blast but is among the 20 wounded, including women and children. It was, however, unclear if the bomb was in a vehicle parked along the lawmaker's route or driven by the bomber. No one has yet claimed responsibility for the blast, which comes amid a sharp rise in violence in recent weeks, and efforts to hold direct peace talks with the Taliban to find an end to the country's almost 20-year-long war. Separate bombings were also reported on Sunday in the provinces of Logar, Nangarhar, Helmand and Badakhshan, in which a number of civilians and security force members were killed and injured. On Friday, a suspected rickshaw bomb blast killed at least 15 civilians, including 11 children, in central Ghazni province.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's president dissolved parliament on Sunday at the request of Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's cabinet and announced that the general elections would be held in April and May, more than a year ahead of schedule. Addressing the nation in the wake of recent political developments, Oli on Monday said he was forced to take the decision after the leaders were preparing to bring no confidence motion against him and impeachment against the president.
Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli on Monday defended his move to recommend the House dissolution, accusing some of his party leaders of being responsible for making him take such step. In address to the nation, Oli said that although the move appears to be unexpected on the surface, the step is actually an outcome of response to act selfishness of some power-hungry leaders within the ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP, which had been broiling since long. Nepal's president dissolved parliament on Sunday at the request of Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's cabinet and announced that general elections would be held in April and May, more than a year ahead of schedule. Following the government's decision, cadres from faction of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, opposition Nepali Congress and the student wings took to the streets of capital Kathmandu on Sunday, denouncing the move. They termed the move as a constitutional coup and demanded both the state and execute head of the nation not to go ahead.
चुनाव त अहिले नेपाल जनताले 5 वर्षको लागि त मेन्डेट दिसक्या हो नि अब अहिले त यो त 3 वर्ष मात्रै हुँदैछ अरु 2 वर्ष त यो हाउसले काम गर्नु पर्यो अनि त्यो पछि मात्रै हुने हो चुनाव यो त एउटा भन्नको लागि भन्दिने कुरा भयो अब अदालतको चाहिँ कोर्टमा चाहिँ यो बल पुग्या छ मलाई लाग्छ अदालतले यसलाई चाहिँ स्वीकार्छ भन्ने लाग्दैन यो चाहिँ संविधानमा नभएको चीज चाहिँ कार्यान्वयन हुन सक्दैन
Meanwhile, opponents of Oli turned to the Supreme Court on Monday to challenge his dissolution of parliament and the calling of an election. Oli's move plunges the Himalayan country, which has seen revolving door governance since street protests restored multi-party democracy in 1990, into political turmoil as it battles the coronavirus pandemic.
As a part of Christmas celebrations, a cake show has kicked off in southern Coimbatore city over the weekend. The 10-day cake show showcases over 30 varieties of cakes, and this year's theme is dedicated to COVID warriors. A cake show organized in India's southern Coimbatore city as part of Christmas celebrations is attracting visitors to their bakery ahead of the festival. The 10-day cake show showcases over 30 varieties of cakes, including shapes of the coronavirus, Noddy, handbag, Santa Claus, toy train, among others. The coronavirus-themed cake was baked to pay tribute to the COVID-19 warriors.
Every year for Christmas, we used to conduct a cake show in our shop. And this year, we have made a wide range of wide varieties of cakes. Theme-wise, like Noddy, Unicorn, we have handbags which attracts ladies. And the uniqueness for this year's cake show is Corona, that is Corona awareness.
Christmas is celebrated with much pomp and show, and also by preparing special dishes for the day across India. Celebrations of Christmas is marked by carols, cakes, candles, glittering Christmas trees and exchange of gifts. However, this year, due to the pandemic, the celebrations are expected to be a low-key affair to prevent the spread of the virus.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.